जी, माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी की थोड़ी सी तबीयत ठीक नहीं, बैठ के बोलने के लिए मैं उन्हें अनुमति देती हूँ।
आई एम एक्सट्रीमली ग्रेटफुल टू यू एंड द ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स फॉर बेयरिंग विद अ लिटिल क्रैम्प।
बैठ के यू कैन जी जी।
Soil deterioration has been the cause of concern and leads to suboptimal utilization of farming resources. Government will initiate a scheme to provide to every farmer a soil health card at a mission mode. I propose to set aside a sum of rupees 100 crore for this purpose and an additional 56 crores to set up 100 mobile soil testing laboratories across the country. There has been a growing concern about the imbalance in the utilization of different types of fertilizers, resulting in the deterioration of the soil. Climate change is a reality which all of us have to face together. Agriculture as an activity is most prone to the vagaries of climate change. To meet this challenge, I propose to establish a national adaptation fund for climate change. As an initial sum of rupees 100 crores will be transferred to the fund. We are committed to sustaining a growth of rupee 4% in agriculture, and for this we will bring technology driven second green revolution with focus on higher productivity and include a protein revolution in an area of major focus. As a large number of landless farmers are unable to provide land title as guarantee, institutional finance is denied to them and they become vulnerable to money lenders. I propose to provide finance to 5 lakh joint farming groups of Bhumihin Kisan through NABARD in the current financial year. Price volatility in agriculture produces and creates certain uncertainties and hardships to the farmers. To mitigate this, I am providing a sum of rupees 500 crores for establishing a price stabilization fund. The farmers' and consumers' interests will be further served by increasing competition and integrating markets across the country. To accelerate the setting up of a national market, the central government will work closely with the state governments to reorient their respective APMCs to provide the establishment of a private market yards, private markets. The state government will also be encouraged to develop farming markets. Farmers markets in townships to enable the farmers to sell their products directly. I propose to set aside a sum of rupees 50 crores for development of indigenous cattle breeding and an equal opportunity of starting a blue revolution in inland fisheries. Banks are providing strong credit support to agricultural sector. A target of 8 lakh crores has been set aside for agriculture credit during 2014-15, for which I am confident that banks will surpass. Under the interest subvention scheme for short-term crop loans, banks are extending loans to farmers at a concessional rate of 7%. The farmers will get a further incentive of 3% for timely repayment. I propose to continue the scheme for 2014-15. NABARD operates the Rural Infrastructure Development Fund out of a priority sector lending shortfall of banks, which helps in creation of infrastructure in agriculture and rural sectors across the country. I propose to raise the corpus of RIDF by an additional 5,000 crores from the target given in the interim budget of 25,000 crores in the current financial year. Increasing warehousing capacity for increasing the shelf life of agriculture produces and thereby earning capacity of the farmers is utmost importance. Keeping in view the urgent need of availability of scientific warehousing infrastructure in the country, I propose an allocation of rupees 5,000 crores for the fund for the year 2014-15. The share of long-term investment credit in agriculture is going down as compared to short-term crop loan. This is severely hampering the asset creation in agriculture and allied activities. In order to give a boost to long-term investment credit in agriculture, I propose to set up a long-term rural credit fund in NABARD for the purposes of providing refinance support to cooperative banks and regional rural banks with an initial corpus of 5,000 crores. The short-term cooperative rural credit refinance fund was introduced in the union budget of 2008 and 2009 with initial corpus of 5,000 crores. In order to ensure increased and uninterrupted credit flow to farmers and to avoid a high cost of market borrowings by NABARD, I propose to allocate an amount of rupees 5,000 crores for the STRC fund during 2014-15. The issue of profitability of small holdings based agriculture has assumed importance in view of increasing proportion of small and marginal farmers in the country. I propose to supplement NABARD's Producers Organization Development Fund for producers development and upliftment called Produce with a sum of rupees 2,200 crores, which will be utilized for building 2,000 producers organizations across the country over the next 2 years. Government is committed to reform in the food sector, restructuring FCI, reducing transportation and distribution losses, and efficacy of PDS would be taken up on priority. Government is also committed to provide wheat and rice at a reasonable price to the weaker sections in the society. Even if due to inadequate rainfall, there is a marginal decline in agricultural production, stocks in the central pool are adequate to meet the exigency. Government shall, when required, undertake open market sales to keep prices under control. Kisan Television, dedicated to the interest of agriculture and allied sectors, will be launched in the current year. This will disseminate real-time information to the farmers in information regarding new farming techniques, water conservation, organic framing. I propose to set aside a sum of rupees 100 crores for this purpose. The e-biz industry. The e-biz platform aids to create a business and investor-friendly ecosystem in India by making all businesses and investments related to clearance and compliances available to 24/7 single portal with an integrated payment gateway. All central government departments and ministries will integrate their services with the e-biz platform on priority by 31st December this year. A national industrial corridor with its headquarters at Pune is being set up to coordinate the deployment of the industrial corridors with smart cities linked to the transport connectivity, which will be the cornerstone of the strategy to drive India's growth in manufacturing and urbanization. I have provided an initial corpus of rupees 100 crores for this purpose. The Amritsar-Kolkata industrial master planning will be completed expeditiously for establishment of an industrial smart cities in 7 states of India. The master planning of these 3 cities, smart cities, is the Chennai-Bengaluru industrial corridor region, the Puneri in Tamil Nadu, Krishnapatnam in Andhra Pradesh, Tumkur in Karnataka will also be completed. The prospective plan for the Bengaluru-Mumbai economic corridor and the Vizag-Chennai corridor would be completed with the provision of 20 new industrial clusters. Kakinada, its adjoining area, and the port will be developed as key drivers of economic growth in the region with special focus on hardware manufacturing. Exports cannot be exponentially increased unless states play a very active role in export promotion by providing good infrastructure and full facilitation. It will be our endeavor to engage the states to take India's export to a higher growth trajectory. It is proposed to establish an export promotion mission to bring all stakeholders under one umbrella. The government is committed to revive the special economic zones and make them effective instruments of industrial production, economic growth, export promotion, and employment generation. For achieving this, effective steps would be undertaken to operationalize the special economic zones, to revive the investors' interests, to develop better infrastructure, to effectively and efficiently use the available unutilized land. Comparing the size of Indian economy, the performance of the apprenticeship training scheme is not satisfactory, and a large number of training facilities in industry are unutilized. Apprenticeship Act will be suitably amended to make it more responsive to the industry and youth. It will also encourage the MSMEs to avail of the benefits under the scheme. The SMEs form the backbone of our economy. They account for a large portion of our industrial output and employment. The bulk of service sector enterprises are also SMEs. Most of our SMEs own account enterprises. Most importantly, a majority of these enterprises are owned and run by SCs, STs and OBCs. Financing of this sector is of critical importance, particularly as it benefits the weakest section. There is a need to examine the financial architecture for this sector. I propose to appoint a committee with representatives from the Finance Ministry, Ministry of MSME, RBI to give concrete suggestions in 3 months. Promotion of entrepreneurship and startup companies remains a challenge. While there has been some effort to encourage, one of the principal limitations has been of startup capital by way of equity to be brought in by promoters. In order to create a conducive ecosystem for a venture capital in the MSME sector, it is proposed to establish a rupees 10,000 crore fund to act as a catalyst to attract private capital by way of providing equity, quasi-equity, soft loan and other risk capitals for startup companies. To establish center network to promote innovation, entrepreneurship and agro industries, I propose to set up a fund with a corpus of 200 crores. The definition of MSME will be revived to provide for a higher capital ceiling. A program to facilitate forward and backward linkages with multiple value chains, manufacturing and service delivery will also be put in place. Entrepreneurship friendly legal bankruptcy framework will also be developed for SMEs to enable easy exit. A nationwide district level incubation and accelerator program would be taken up for an incubation and new ideas and providing necessary support for accelerating entrepreneurship. I propose to set up trade facilitation center and a craft center with a museum with an outlay of 50 crores to develop and promote handloom products and carry out the rich tradition of handlooms of Varanasi, where I intend to support textile mega clusters. I also propose to set up 6 more textile clusters in Bareilly, Lucknow, Surat, Kutch, Bhagalpur, Mysore and in Tamil Nadu. I am allocating a sum of rupees 200 crore for this purpose. I also propose I also propose to set up a Hastakala Academy for preservation, revival and documentation of the handloom handicraft sector in the PPP mode in Delhi. I have set aside a sum of rupees 30 crores for this purpose. I propose to set up a Pashmina production program P3 and a program for development of other crafts in Jammu and Kashmir. I have set aside a sum of rupees 50 crores for this purpose. India has